All right, so back to this. Don't even know what part we're on. Part 28. Actually, decent way through. Halfway through the it's the Dueling Hearts, right? And we left off at kind of an interesting point. A big thing we saw, right, in kind of the previous part is the I guess kind of, the rest of the interaction between what would you call it? The MC, Sam, and then Sayori, right there, and ultimately, their commitment to proving his innocence, right? As well as again, more of a, I'd say really more of a learning somewhat, about the backstory of Sam, pretty much just confirming and cementing what we already knew, but really what is kind of, I guess, the MC have thought about, but then also kind of them more so getting into the discussion, the deeper discussions on like life and whatnot, right? But really, I guess the big thing is clearing the air between them three. So kind of again, seeing who's still, with Michael, after the fallout of this, right? At least there's three or two, but again, you can potentially include more in that, right? Shiro knows for a fact that, Michael's innocent, given this is the same thing that's happened to him. And again, he managed to semi-convince Kayla and Ruby to hear him out as well as hear Michael out, so seemingly maybe two other people. And now we're seeing this interaction between Shiro and Yuri, right? Shiro kind of was hallucinating for a moment, right? And Yuri kind of being the one to snap him out of it. I find this to be a very interesting like this is a very interesting interaction. Particularly because first off, Charlotte isn't dead, right? That's not the case. Obviously, we know she's in the hospital, right? Likely suffering from a panic attack. Again, the last we saw her, she was getting a mori, right after Michael beat the fuck out of Kai. But again, she's not dead, right? Like, I don't know why that's being, I guess, that's what's being shown or thrown around, right? But again, there's that, right? But the second thing is, again, we know in this, Yuri's with Adrian, right? So again, the interesting thing, and because given, even though Adrian despises Shiro, right, definitely what's the term? Adrian is there's a better term, or he's a bit I don't know. But again, he doesn't like Shiro, so Yuri kind of confronting him here is a bit interesting. Especially given that Monica, she knows Monica personally, right? Being a part of the club, and she knows that Monica was the one who Shiro again, who was the victim of Shiro's actions, right? So, and again, I mean, this is a pretty big deal. So, like, what do you mean the energy to be at home? Like, what the hell does that even mean? Like, your parents hate you? Like, the fuck do you mean? Like, because, I mean, listen, let's be real here, right? This doesn't mean that, Shiro is a good person, right? Or that he's even a victim, right? But it is something to where. Because it'd be one thing again if kind of the club split up, Michael moved, but now again with again the with what would you call it, the incident, right? What happened with Michael, that all of a sudden complicates things, right? It's like him, I guess, in a sense, reliving what he went through a year ago all over again. But again, right? So, and again, she's not fucking dead. Like, she's not dead. Like, why? Let's see. And again, but And I also, what I view as crazy is seemingly this all stemmed from Shiro's manipulation of her into rejecting Kai, right? Like, seemingly it all stems from that. So, past interesting. So, I feel like this is the point in the game to where we're finally, because we got through the anime club arc kind of to set up, and then we got through the investigation arc, which kind of, brought into, the conflict, right? Again, that was kind of the climax. The interesting thing here now is we're getting a lot of backstory on these characters. We're getting more backstory in the MC. We got more backstory on Sam, right? Now we're getting backstory on Charlotte. So again, her dad, right? Let's see. Her being very fundamentalist. I guess that was a way to put it. I said evangelicalist earlier, but again, there's a difference there. Like, I guess more orthodox. So, but also, again, the interesting thing is that, like, again, it's the science and religion aspect, right? But also, to be fair, Shiro's a writer. You can't forget that. Let's see. Few traumatic head injuries throughout the years. Damn, for what? Like, this we actually unironically have not, like, this is completely new to us. We have not known about this. All right, so it's unironically, actual, like, let's see. Bruh, Jesus fucking Christ. They really had to give her some fucking backstory, like superhero backstory. What the hell is this? Like, it could have gone without this. They really had to give her some fucking superhero backstory. Like, see. Let's see. And again, this is why it's like, but also, like, it's crazy that she's acting like to be fair, like, it sucks. Because, like, let's be real, like, she was what, 10 when she got the first, and it was slipping in the shower, right? And then what was it? Whatever, when she fell in the well, right? I'll say, fine enough, though, I have not broken a bone, but I have broken my nose. And it was from, again, shower escapades, right? Slipping in the shower too. So, can't really blame her for that. And it sucks that that actually led to, like, permanent damage on her end. Like, because that's something to where you're gonna have to live with that now, compared to, other people who don't have to deal with that. So it absolutely sucks, dealing with that, right? And that'd be something that would 100% piss me off. But the other thing there is, it's like that doesn't all of a sudden make you a victim in an instance like this. Like, I hate the wording of this. I absolutely despise it. Because even though Kai is no longer redeemable, right, far past it, like, they're still, like, she can't act as if she was the victim in this situation, right? Like, this, again, especially with the way that went down. So, I mean, the only person to blame for that is Shiro himself. Like, I'm gonna be honest. Okay, to be fair, it's kind of on Charlotte. But, Shiro was the one who manipulated her into doing that to begin with. And he still has not accepted responsibility for it. I will say Charlotte did, and now obviously she's, I guess the mod's acting as if she's dead, but Shiro still has not accepted responsibility for that. Like, horse rides for Jesus fucking Christ, dude. Like, see. And again, that's why I'm like, she's not fucking dead. Like, boy, join in it, because, again, now she has her own friends in the club, right? So, bruh, what? Shut the fuck up. Dude, I hate this man so goddamn much. Also, there's no way they're gonna, I mean, all right, because I see what they're trying to do here, right? What they're trying to get at. Like, they're trying to make the relation or comparison between Shiro and Yuri, which, again, I guess maybe in the sense that they're more what would you call it? Like from a surface level, I can see it, but the problem is when you get into like more of their personalities, like it's just not there. Like, given what we've seen of Shiro and what we know about Yuri, like there's kind of no relation. The mob's gonna try to act that way. But at the end of the day, right? Like I fucking hate this man, Shiro, dude. And also, like, it's interesting because we know Adrian, despises Shiro, right? Or there's a better term for it. It's a D term. I can't think of it. Or he's I don't remember the term, but there's a good term to use for it. I guess he's sort of distrusting, he's what would you call it? He has disdain. Yeah, disdain. He has disdain towards Shiro, so it's interesting that these two are seemingly, because obviously Adrian's not gonna be pleased. Dude, shut the fuck up, bro. Like, that's kind of facts though, because this whole middle school thing, because when I went from grade school to middle school, it was a combination of two separate grade schools, right? Or I guess elementary, whatever you call it. And middle school is just sometimes called junior high. But then when I entered high school, it was a combination of, I think, six different middle schools. Again, who knows there? So, see, but I mean, okay, dude, I was about to say, we're about to get backstory on Yuri. So, Monica, what the fuck was her last name? It was something stupid. But again, we know the whole reason why she left was because, it was her and the current debate club president, right? Kind of having a falling out. Similar to Natsuki's reason, Natsuki and Kayla, right, for the anime club. So, yeah, and again, Sayori, right? That's why it's like, she hasn't changed a bit. Again, we know her via the MC as well as Sam, so. And again, because Monica, right? What's her relation in all this? I guess, I mean, I don't see how she would that really be really that affected by this. It's not as though she was close to Charlotte or even Kayla and Ruby. I guess, well, actually, that's a lie. Because the whole reason why Kai targeted, or how Kai was able to bring Valerie on, was given that, Charlotte was friends with Monica, right? So that's actually, like, I completely backtracked that. I completely forgot that was the reason why. And again, this is, like, if anything, that goes to show how, I guess, what's the term? I guess just how efficient, practical and pragmatic Kai is, right? In terms of, how he gets things done, right? Utilizing others' own motives for his own benefit, right? So, again, so, and again, Jeremy, right? But the big thing being, we know Jeremy, it's interesting seeing this because no one's really acknowledged it with the exception of the MC, right? But Jeremy having a kind of falling out with Kai, right? Just interesting to note and take into consideration there, especially given that, I mean, the whole mods tried to make it seem like, oh, Team Kai versus Team Shiro. But some were complicated. So Jeremy, again, honestly, I'm really interested to see what Jeremy's going to ultimately do, right? Because it's also, to be fair, the mods tried to, punk on the principal, right? But the principal gave the MC as fair of a deal as he was going to get. So, So I'd say in the meantime, I have pretty high, like, opinions of both Jeremy and the principal, but again, just something interesting to point out. And again, and again, right? But, and I guess kind of the idea here is she would be in a similar, I guess, position or situation as Shiro, or they have kind of a mutual friend there, right? And again, Shiro's saying, like, yeah, it's a horrible idea. So, again, right? And I think the point there being, you'd think, people like, let's say Monica, right? Because obviously this happened to Charlotte. She doesn't know that Valerie is, in on it, right? Like, she doesn't know that. Again, that's the part of the reason why this was able to be carried out. But I think something there that's interesting is, again, the fact that this happened, and that's why I'm saying, like, I feel like it was, all right, let's be real here, right? It was very easy to believe, you know, that Shiro did what he did, right? The problem with this incident that Kai kind of staged is that if you start to take a look at it, right, it kind of starts to fall apart. You know, again, something where it's like, again, it really kind of starts to fall apart there. So, you know, it's something ultimately that where it's like, you know, again, just something to point out, because at the end of the day, right, you know, maybe that's something that, like, even over that could be something that convinces Machina, you know, oh, maybe these things didn't actually happen, right? So, and I guess the idea is that's not Machina helping Shiro. Right? It's Shiro helping Monica, I guess, repaying her for, again, you know, her helping him, right? So, but also I find it interesting because, again, we know Shiro is with Adrian, who has disdain toward Shiro and is part of the club. So, shut the fuck up, bro. Dude's having a hallucination. Like, bro, she's not fucking dead. What the? I swear, Shiro's delusional, dog. So, yeah, she's not dead. Like, and again, right? So, and again, Sayori brings up the point there, right? So, you brought company? Bruh, this is gonna be a stupid ass comment to where it's like, it's Shiro. Like, you say that as if you didn't immediately fucking notice when he walked in. Like, that's why I'm like, bro, like, bruh, dude. And again, this is like, and again, this was something I hated about Natsuki and despised her character. Obviously, she was friends with Shiro, right? And, you know, I feel like this is something I'm still gonna point out. Shiro is friends with Shiro, and Monica was a victim of, you know, again, the incident, right, with Shiro, however long ago. Even despite the fact that he edited it, like, that it, or that it was edited by Kai, right? That doesn't exclude his behavior and the fact that he had such a thing with him at school to begin with. And the fact that Natsuki didn't care about that at all, and or Mako, and only wants Shiro to be a part of the club because they're friends. Like, again, like, it's kind of like she doesn't care about anyone but herself, you know? But, right, again, I feel like that's kind of, let's see. Fucking fat ass, bro. Mountain, shut the fuck up, dude. Shut up. Oh my god, dude. I fucking hate this guy, bro. Oh my god, shut up, man. I hate this guy so goddamn much. Dude, just why the hell, dude? This is like base game MC levels of fucking stupidity. Why the hell would you even fucking say this, dude? Why the hell would you say this, dude? Like, what the hell is this, doc? I fuck it. Of course we know you're Mountain Dew guy, fat ass. Jesus Christ. Why would you even say this? Fucking Shiro, dude. I swear to God. I think this bro, give it in the fucking diesel, you know. Well, what is it? Green tea. Dude, that is what the hell are you fucking talking? Those are not that, whatever, man. You know. Special, bruh, what are they, fucking weed brownies? Like, why, like, are they fucking weed brownies? Like, you know, Natsuki growing her own. To be fair, what is, hold on. Because what was it that, like, this game had a crazy fucking confession about Natsuki that she, like, I'm a fucking dumbass. I thought that when it was referring to Natsuki smoking, it meant fucking cigarettes. And I was like, damn, that's crazy. Natsuki's a fucking Of course it's fucking weed, dude. Like, I hate these people, bro. Also, it, like, I don't think Shiro and Adrian, like, because we know Adrian is big, like, despite the fact that I guess now hit Shiro and Yuri are on good terms, like, what? Shut up, you fuck, dude. Listen, I don't know who needs to hear this, but like, smoking weed doesn't make you cool. Like, I think it was a much bigger thing in like the mid to late 2010s, but like, you know, being a stoner and a fucking, you know, being like a freaking junkie like that, right? Doesn't make you cool. Like, I don't know who needs to hear that, but you know, granted, like if you just do it, right? You know, or like some people do it for medicinal reasons, but some people just do it. But if you don't make it your whole fucking personality, right? Like, we get it, Noski. You smoke fucking weed. Congratulations. You know, you don't need to bring it up every fucking, you know, conversation. Shut the hell up, dude. I fucking hate you all, dude. Like, let's see. So, hold on, what did she say? All right, so now again, it's in Brasa George's dips. Now it's just these two, because obviously we know. Because, and again, here's the thing, right? Like, I don't feel bad for Shiro in the slightest. Even if you, because the game and mod tries to put it all on the fact that it was edited. But even if you, it like, you know, what would you call it? Like, you know, but even excluding that, right? Like the fact that A, Shiro had creepy and predatory behavior towards Maka, as well as B, the fact that he had such a thing to begin with, especially at school, is pretty fucking ridiculous and something you can't really just overlook like that. So, Snapchat? Bro, what? Who? Bitch, people fucking posting that shit on Snapchat. What the hell? And again, like, and listen, Maka's not like, listen, I feel like, because let's put it this way. Despite what you might think about the current generation, you know, especially it's weird because a lot of Gen Z try to clown on Gen A. It's like, bro, like, you know, do you not remember to, like, five, six, however long ago when we were getting clowned on by millennials? Like, goddamn, mom, lack of self-awareness. Most people aren't fucking idiots, right? Most people have a certain level of common sense and like rationality, like a baseline. You know, most people are gonna look at those and realize, wait a second, he couldn't have fucking taken those. It was in the girls' fucking locker room. Even if they don't assume, like, oh, why the hell are these signed by him? Like, they're gonna be like, oh, he didn't fucking. Like, most people, you know, granted, again, you know, the, I guess, working theory would be that Michael would have someone else take him, but. And again, he immediately assumes it's Kai. Like, and Manka brings up a good point here. Because Kai is, you know, but obviously we know the reason why he was able to do something like this was because, again, you know, it was personal with Charlotte, right? Obviously, she doesn't know the past history between Kai, Shiro, and Charlotte, right? The only people who know about that are. Obviously them three, the MC, who else? Kayla and Ruby, right? So, but also like Shiro, you made him that way. Like, I don't know how else to say it, but Shiro has a helping hand in making him that way, right? And that he's never accepted responsibility for, by the way. So, but also again, you know, but it, here's the thing. Has Shiro even apologized? I don't. I'm trying to remember back to the win interaction they had where he was in the club. Obviously, he thanked Monica, but I don't recall if he ever, like, Shiro just cannot fucking apologize or accept responsibility for anything. But, you know, and again, obviously, Shiro is just, and again, it shows you really, like, honestly, I'm not, like, I still don't, like, see Shiro in a good light. Like, I still don't see him as, like, a victim in all this, right? Like, I don't have empathy or sympathy for him at all. Like, you know, and again, like the, like, he's not even saying, like, he's like trying to be like, oh yeah, I'm a victim too. Like, no, like, if anything, fucking, you need to be like, you know, I don't want to say kiss the ass, but at least like fucking apologize and like don't try to make this about yourself, which is seeming all he's done so far. Like, I will say, I did know someone like Shiro in real life, not like, manner, like their big thing. Okay, they were kind of fat too, but their whole thing was that they were very much into leftist political theory. And it's something to where it's like they like obviously, I studied political science, but it was never really like something like it was my fucking degree, right? So I never really got that much into, outside of it. But people who are into like people are in that stuff to like out like super into that stuff outside of their, degree plan, right? You need, and especially if it's leftist political theory, right? Because that's in something that's inherently based in morality, right? Again, substitution politics with morality. I was gonna write a paper on that, my culminating paper, but I just never ended up needing to do it. But again, something to where because of that, right? You get a lot more self-righteous, which again comes from a place of ego. And so what's the term? Fucking I guess self-centered knowledge, or assumption of knowledge of the world and the way things work. But again, besides completely besides the point. But the thing was that he always made everything about himself, right? It was completely unrelated to his again, his own like political beliefs. It was more so just that was the big thing he was on versus Shiro, who's just your typical rat fucking nerd, right? But that was just what I wanted to throw out there, but they always made everything about themselves, and that's what Shiro does, right? Michael's not like me. He's not so showy with his emotions. Kind of facts. He's also not an asshole. Like, he's not arrogant and he's not fucking, what would you call it? He doesn't have a victim mentality. Like, But also, it's why, and this is why it's like, it really kind of, surprised me that I guess Shiro kind of to an extent, but especially Kayla and Ruby couldn't, like, understand at all Michael's reasons for leaving the club. Like, honestly, like it kind of surprised me, But also, it's like, let's see. And again, that's why it's like, I feel like he, my Monica doesn't know the past between them, but given again what we know, right? Like, we know that this would be an instance where Kai would be willing to go that far, given it's personal, right? So. But here's the thing, right? And again, Shiro, of course, is making this about himself as fucking usual, right? Can't stop fucking making it about himself. But if anything, this cut, because here's the thing. Obviously, he d deleted the recording, but like, this isn't as good of track coverage as Shiro's. I talk about how once you start to think about it, you start to see the holes, right? So, the discrepancies there. But also, dude, of course, dude, I hate this guy so goddamn much. He always makes fucking everything about him. He's like, oh, I'm the victim here. This way to, like, dude, like, if you don't think Kai and then Michael didn't do it, who could have? Valerie. And again, the funny thing is, this is actually really interesting that Monica immediately assumes Valerie, given again, obviously her past relation with her. And funny enough, I talked about how this entire thing would fall apart if they get a hold of the person who actually took the picture, which we know is Valerie, right? Granted, it was supposed to be Bella, or no, it wasn't even Valerie. It was Bella. Valerie had her last second doubts, but it wasn't until Bella took it and she re was reminded of Monica, right? So, and again, right? Not that I know of, but also we know, funny enough, that it literally was Valerie. Right. So, but also again, that's why it's like it is a mutually beneficial within 10 feet of him. No one can say, bro, Kai, freaking Bella, like every team with you literally hit the net. Like, I feel like this is because obviously you have no way to, I mean, the MC got in a fucking fight with Kai, and basically Kai himself confirmed that he did it, as well as, but again, right? Like, Valerie wasn't ever confronted. Who confronted Bella about, or it was Kayla and Ruby confronted Bella about the rumors, but, and again, right? Monica brings up a good point there. Like, I mean, obviously it's correct, But also, like, I feel like Shiro's a fucking idiot here. Like, and this is what I've been saying this whole time. Shiro needs to, this is what Shiro needs to fucking do. Sit down, shut up. Don't fucking say anything else. Just make your way through the rest of high school and then make something of yourself in college. Like, Shiro does not need to be like, he is like so badly, like, he has like zero fucking control over his emotions, dude. Like, he's so fucking immature. Like, he really just needs to fucking sit down, shut up, and make it through the rest of high school. Like, again, you know, like, honestly, like, really the big thing that you need to do is, again, what Monica's saying, wait until you hear back from Charlotte, right? Like, you don't need a whole fucking investigation like she did. Because, again, you know, how, like, that was the whole reason this happened, right? You know, there. Napoleon? Oh, there is nothing we can do. I hate that so much. There is nothing we can do. But so, all right, Shiro, go and do it. I hope you fucking die, dude. Like, all right, damn, that's crazy. Go and do it. I, you know, all right, go and do, dude. I hate Shiro so fucking much, bro. I hope to God he's not, like, he's still my least favorite character and easily my most hated in this mod. I hope to God he's not this bad in Take Two, because that's, you know, the one I'm gonna be playing after. I hate his character so fucking much, dude. Like, I'll make him, dude. Kai's in a fucking hospital too. Like, the MC fucked him up. All right, go and do it. You know, like, all right, go and do it. What do you mean we fucking we dumbass? Go and do it. Also, literally the only person in the club room is Monica. Like, and how? All right, fucking go and do it. Like, honestly, Monica just needs to be like, all right, you know, if you want to go do it, go do it. You know, like, bro, what the hell is it, a metaphor? And again, why do you think this happened to Charlotte? Because what's crazy to think about is, dude, I find this whole thing crazy. Because if you think about it, Shiro's the reason why, again, Kai ended up the way he did. I feel like the funny thing is, if Charlotte had never investigated, this incident would have never happened. You know, and Michael wouldn't be the way he is, right? Like, it's kind of crazy, you know? Because, again, one thing I still hate is that people never took into account Shiro being a shitty person, being part of the reason why the MC left the club. So, I go, just let him fucking leave, Monica. Like, let him leave. Like, if he's gonna be this arrogant about it, let him fucking leave. I mean, this is the reason why, you know, he manipulated Charlotte into rejecting him to begin with. This man's a fucking arrogant asshole. Like, this is why no one likes him. Like, just let him. Like, dude, I really, where the hell did she come from? I thought she was gone. Like, all right, then leave. Leave. Bye. See ya. Like, goddamn. See ya. Bye. See ya. You know, get out of here. See ya. Don't need you. Bye. You know, you're gone. See ya. Bye. All right. See you. We're done here. Like, don't, you know, don't have anything else. All right. There we go. Goddamn. You know, shut the fuck up, Shiro. Like, I hate this man so goddamn much, dude. I feel zero empathy or sympathy for him. Like, no remorse. Like, let's see. That, and Charlotte, and again, Charlotte, I will say, I do respect Charlotte for calling Shiro out on his bullshit. Like, Shiro, I fucking hate that man so goddamn much. Like, I hate him just as much, if not more, than Kai or Jeremy or anyone else. Like, I'm so glad Charlotte called Shiro. Like, otherwise, I'd say Charlotte's just as equally as shitty of a character as Shiro, given the her part and helping hand in this. But the fact that she actually called Shiro out, and funny thing, I find this hilarious. Charlotte did actually bring up a point, you know, maybe he hasn't crossed, but she went into that interaction with the intent of recording an entrapment. I've said if she led off with a genuine apology and asking for forgiveness, maybe things could have been different. But obviously, that wasn't what happened. So, you know. See, I mean, I do think that this was kind of, that event horizon, right? Kai's no longer redeemable in my eyes, in my mind. But I do think well, first off, he could have never ended up the way he did, right? If Shiro just wasn't as arrogant, much of an arrogant asshole as he was. But also, if, Charlotte went into that conversation with the intent of actually, redeeming him versus entrapping him, right? Let's see. Damn, that's crazy. But also, dude, I fucking hate you are the fucking reason. Like, you are the reason why things ended up this way. And he just can't fucking ex like, I really hate Shiro's character. Like, it is all your fault. Yeah, you're fucking, Let's see. I hope he fucking does and gets him. Just let him. Just let him. Let him make the stupid fucking choice, and that way we don't have to deal with him anymore. Just let him. Let him. Let him do it. Like, I don't get why people are trying. This guy's the most arrogant fucking asshole. Like, and people keep trying to, like, convince him of things. Like, just let him fucking do it and let him fail, right? Sometimes you gotta let people fucking fail. Like, I don't feel bad for, like, boo hoo, wah wah, cry. I really do not feel bad for this person. I don't care about him. Like, I really fucking don't. Like, yeah, you are. You're fucking pathetic, dude. Like, I hate this man so goddamn much. Like, zero empathy, zero fucking sympathy. I've got nothing for this man. You do deserve it. You deserve fucking. Bitch. They make some actual. Oh, wait. No. All right. Also, but this is a good point to end it. And also, like, damn, they actually made him look not too. Okay, dude, all right. His fucking body size and proportion is crazy. They slimmed down his face in this artwork, but they made him fucking fat as fuck. I'm not even gonna lie. But also, like, we know Adrian's disdain for Shiro. He's not gonna like this. I just wanna throw that out there. But I also feel, I do not feel, you can't make me feel bad for Shiro, given until this man learns to A, accept responsibility for his actions. He's never apologized for anything. He's never accepted responsibility for anything, right? Never. We haven't seen him do it once. We've seen him admit he was wrong and then immediately backtrack by trying to justify it. Like, this man does not accept that. Two, he's arrogant and an asshole. Like, you cannot convince this man to, like, change his mind on anything, right? And then three, again, the fact that he's the entire reason this, like, whole thing started, like, unironically, you can cough this all up to him and his manipulation of Charlotte, right? Like, this can literally all be coughed back up. For as bad as you feel for that man, this can literally all be coughed back up to this incident, right? Even though, again, like I said, I do believe that Kai's irredeemable in this instance. He's gone far beyond, again, that there was the event horizon. Like, you still have to blame Shiro and Charlotte for, causing that, right? I mean, I don't know what else to say there, but with that, I don't really have anything else to say. That's really all I got for this one. So, yep, that's it for this one. See you in the next one.